Dr. Martin here again with a short video introducing the Microsoft Word assignment. Since this is the first application in the Office Suite, I wanted to just give you a little bit of a rundown on how these are going to go. And it'll be the same when we do Excel and PowerPoint. So first of all, this is the first time we're going to be using the Office books. This book here is where all of the tutorials are, all of the content, and we're going to open up to the Word section, and then start here. Now, it's important that you read these couple of first pages here before the tutorials start, because some of the questions in the quiz are based on this content. So you're going to open these up a little bit, read, and then right here is where we're going to start the tutorials. The tutorials are to prepare you for the homework assignment. You will need the student data files to complete these tutorials and the homework, and I'll talk about that here in a second. You do not turn in the files from the tutorials, just the homework assignment, just the review assignment. And there'll be three assignments and three files for you to turn in and upload. The homework, the review questions aren't in this book. Just this edition, they've separated out and put them in the workbook. If you bought your book bundle from the bookstore, this came with it. If you didn't, it didn't come with it. But lucky for you, I made some color copies and put them up on the website, and I'll show you those here in a second. So I'm going to do a little screen share of the class page, and then we'll come back to the book when it's time. So give me 1 second here. Okay, so here we are back at the course page. Now the section looks like, you know, there's a lot of stuff here, but don't be worried. A lot of it's just extra stuff for you to use as a reference or a guide. Okay, so first thing we're going to do is we are going to click on the Microsoft Word 2016 link right up here, which gives us an overview of the assignments and what you actually need to complete. So as we start the Word assignment, first know that you have 2 weeks to complete the Word assignment, okay, for online students and for in-person students. Now, if your class is a short-term class, like over the summer, or maybe it's only 6 weeks long, you won't have 2 weeks, but you'll notice in the due dates that it shows the due date for the assignment right here, September 11th. Which is 2 weeks away, okay? So click on the Microsoft Office 2016 link, and this is what we are gonna be doing in the next 2 weeks, okay? We're gonna complete Word Assignments 1, Word Assignment 2, and Word Assignment 3, and we're gonna complete the Word quiz, okay? And then I give you the little note, hey, don't forget about the student data files. You're gonna need them, okay? So let's go back. And you'll notice that I have linked from this page Word Assignment 1, 2, and 3, and I've also linked the student data files back at that page. Now, then we're going to complete the quiz. I've included some practice quizzes here for fun. I've included the PowerPoints for you to look at if you want, but you don't have to look at these PowerPoints, okay? Please make sure you read the couple of pages in front of the Word text and do all the tutorials, because the quiz is based on that content. All right. So first, let's talk about the student data files. Click on the student data files link. You must have the student data files to complete the assignments. During the tutorials and for the review assignments, you're going to be asked to open up a specific file. Those files are found right here in the student data files. Now, if you bought your book through the bookstore, you might have had a CD come with it with the data files on it. You might have had a little code or a little piece of paper that told you where you could go to the publisher's website. That's fine. You can do all that, but I've included them here for your convenience. So we're going to click on this link. You'll notice that down here in the lower left, here it is, the student data files are downloading. Okay? If not, if they don't start downloading, then click Save As. And now this file is a compressed file. Okay, you can see it has a little zipper on it. So we need to extract all the files in this folder. Okay, so I'm going to click on this little arrow. Now, if you have a Mac, sorry, I can't help you. But on a PC, you see this little arrow down here. You click on that, and I like to say Show in Folder. That way I know exactly where I've saved it to. It's in Downloads. Okay, so I'm going to double click on the student data files. Okay, and then I'm going to look at this tab here, Extract tab, and I'm going to click on Extract All. It asks me where I want to extract the files to. It's going to put them in student data files under an unzipped folder, student data files 1. Fine. Click on Extract. And there it goes. Okay, so now the files are extracted. It is in Downloads under Student Data Files 1. And if I click here, I will see that I have all of these folders. Okay, I have folders for Word, PowerPoint, Excel, and Access. Okay, so these are all the data files you will need for the entire class. You only have to do this one time. Now, if you are completing this in an in-person class, you're going to want to save these to a thumb drive. If you're going to do some of your homework in the lab, put these on a thumb drive. If you're going to use more than one computer to complete your homework, put these on a thumb drive. And by a thumb drive, I mean a USB memory stick. So here it is right here. Mine's got a little, here it pops it out. I'm going to put this into my computer. Here is my thumb drive down here, Tom's Lexar. I'm going to go back to this folder. I'm going to click this folder and drag it over here. I'm going to drop it right into my thumb drive. Now, while this is transferring, I'm going to give you a couple other tips here. Okay? So here is my thumb drive. Right. When I got this, it didn't say Tom's Lexar, it just said Lexar. So I right-clicked on my thumb drive, and I clicked on Rename. I suggest you type in your first name, apostrophe S. It will rename the thumb drive, and every time you plug it in, no matter what computer you're at, it's going to come up with your name on it, so you'll know which one of these drives it is. Yours might not look as busy as mine, but I need to have names so that I realize which one, which thumb drive I have and which drive I have. So that's why I'm going to put Lexar back in there. Okay. Now, the next thing you should do is, because we often forget our thumb drive in the computer, right? We'll walk away, we'll leave class, we'll leave the lab. Our thumb drive will still be there. Chances are, it got put in lost and found, and no one knows it's yours. So what you're going to do is you're going to open up a notepad document. You're going to click on File, Save As. You're going to save this to your thumb drive. Don't put it in any folder. Just save it right to the thumb drive. This is called the root directory. So when someone opens the thumb drive, they're going to see this file. I want you to name this file Owner Info and click Save. Okay, then you're going to type in your name. Put something like, if found, please return. And then put in your phone number, maybe an email. click again, file, save. I can close this now, and now there it is in the root directory of my thumb drive. And that way, if I leave my thumb drive in the lab and someone says, oh, this is some guy's named Tom's thumb drive, and they open it up because they really, really would like to return it to the owner, they'll see owner info. They can open it up. They can give me a call and say, dude, I found your thumb drive. And I'll say, oh my goodness, thank you so much, because I had all this stuff in there I really didn't want to lose. Okay, so please do that. So now I have in here the student data files on my thumb drive, owner info. Okay, now once I get to, well, I think it's like the third tutorial in Word, it's going to ask me to open up the Word S1 folder and find FCT Vacation Specials. And you're going to open it up, and then it's going to tell you to make some changes. Okay, all of that are found. All those files are found. All of those files are found in the thumb drive. So make sure that, or sorry, in the student data files. All of those files are found in the student data files. When you are working in Word Section 1, the first thing that it's going to have you do after you open up a file is rename it and then save it again. Save it to the same folder, Word S1 folder. After you've done Word Section 1, you've completed all the tutorials and the homework, all of those files should be in this folder. And then you'll move on to Word Section 2. Again, all the files are here, and save your files, your documents that you make in here as well. Makes it really easy to find. Okay, so now we have the student data files. Let's go back. Okay, so again, PowerPoints if you want them. So I'm going to click on the first Word assignment. And there's going to be three of them. They'll be just like this. Here it is. Begin Word Assignment 1 by reading Introducing Word 2016. Those are the few pages at the beginning of the Word section. Then read on through Word Section 1, creating and editing a document. There's one or two pages there before the tutorials. Then perform activities or tutorials 1.1 through 1.14 in Word Section 1 on pages Word 2 through Word 32. Okay, so I'm going to go back to the screen here. Okay, so again, this is saying, right, we're going to read these couple of files or a couple of pages in front of the Word section, and then we're going to come to activity 1.1, okay, the first tutorial, and you're going to read through every step, right? The first thing it wants you to do is at the Windows 10 desktop, open Word, and then at the Word blank document template, and they show you a picture, look at all of the different features and new things in Word 2016. And you're going to read every step and do this step by step. You're going to go to the next page. It's going to have you start typing things in. Okay, you're going to continue. You're going to save it. Sometimes it asks you to print. You don't have to print if you don't want. Don't print on campus. If you want to print, print at home. Okay, and you're going to save this file back to the Word S1 folder in the student data files on your USB drive. Okay, then you're going to turn the page, and look here, activity 1.2, and you're going to continue to do these activities here, okay, step by step, tells you everything you need to do. Now, once you get to activity 3, it says go to the student data files in Word Section 1, open up that file, okay, that's where you're going to find it, in Word Section 1 folder in the student data files. Then it's going to ask you to rename it and immediately save it again. That way you're not messing up the original. If you make a mistake, then you can always delete that file, go back to the original, and start again. So make sure you rename it, save it again under the new name, so you don't mess up the original. Okay, so you're gonna do that all through Word Section 1 to activity 1.14. Okay, after 1.14, it just, the chapter just ends right here. And then it goes on to words section two, right? So now is the time when you're going to open up the workbook and you're going to do the skills review for words section one. Okay, now if you don't have the workbook, if we go back to the webpage, you'll notice I have a link here. If you click on that link, it's going to download a PDF. Open that PDF. Look at that. Here is Skills Review 1, just like that's in the workbook. And scroll down, and here is Skills Review 2. Okay, you're going to open up the file, FCT Hawaiian Specials. You're going to make all these changes. And afterwards, after Review 2, Step 4, you don't have to print. You're going to have this document right here, 1-FCT Hawaiian Specials. You're going to upload that to the Dropbox in the Word Assignment 1 homework area. Okay, there's a Dropbox for that assignment. Okay, and then you're done with Word Assignment 1. We go back, and you do Word Assignment 2. And Word Assignment 2 is, guess what? Read some stuff, do some tutorials, and then do the skills review. When you're done with that, go to Word Assignment 3. Word Assignment 3. Read some stuff, do some tutorials, and do the skills review. Okay, make sure you complete all the Word assignments before you attempt the quiz. I have some practice quizzes here for you. And then you take the word quiz. And again, you have 2 weeks to complete these assignments. Okay? I just wanted to give you those tips. I know that for an online class, sometimes it's kind of hard to understand what you're supposed to do. So there's usually in the in-person class, we have a lot of questions. So I just wanted to kind of do what I do in class to help you out and get you started on the right track. Okay, so it's going to be great. You're going to learn a lot with Word. And if you have any questions, send me an email. There is tutoring available in the 700 building. They're open quite a lot, sometimes into the evenings on the weekends as well. There's also this cool thing. And again, I got to do share my screen. There's this cool thing on the course page. You scroll up here, it says Net Tutor, online tutoring, okay? If you click there and choose the office, let's see what we get here. Click on that tutor, hopefully it'll, oh, here we go. So it said, what do you want to do? Well, it's not really computer science, so let's click on business tutor, and then we can call that number and get some live help, okay? You could do this for all of your classes, okay? So Spanish, physics, nursing, math, right? Free tutoring, computer science if you're into programming, right? And it's free. There's no cost to you. They're open for most of the day, and you can get some help from a professional. We have an account with them, so everything's taken care of. So if you have any other questions or you need some additional help, then send me an email through the class page, and have a great time doing Word, and I'm sure I'll see you soon.